Print email, Facebook, Twitter, more. Paddy Moriarty inquest. Larrimah local told don't do anything stupid after argument for Anne Hodgetts, owner of the Larrimah Tea House, has told an inquest into the disappearance of Paddy Moriarty that she told a companion not to do anything stupid after he had an argument with Mr. Moriarty days before his disappearance. Mr. Moriarty, 70, was last seen leaving the local pub on December 16, 2017. Yesterday, an inquest into his suspected death heard Mr. Moriarty was a happy-go-lucky man, but he had an ongoing dispute with Ms. Hodgetts, whose tea house was across from Mr. Moriarty's property on the Stuart Highway. Witnesses told yesterday's hearing the pair detested each other, and would frequently hurl abuse at one another. On Friday, she told the inquest the pair had been neighborly, but things turned sour when Mr. Moriarty stole her son's umbrella in 2010. Although police did not find evidence that this happened, he was angry. Ms. Hodgetts said Mr. Moriarty then began to scare her customers away from the tea house. "He started abusing my customers, threatening tourists and scaring them away from my business," she said. Ms. Hodgetts testified that she'd been to hell and back over the next 10 years, with a series of accusations of property damage and theft. "I've never abused him and I've done nothing for what he did to me. Years ago I went crook at him, once," she said. 4 days before Mr. Moriarty's disappearance, Ms. Hodgetts accused him of dragging a dead kangaroo over to her property, but denied she retaliated. "I swear to God, I couldn't move a kangaroo," she said. The following day, the inquest heard her companion, Owen Laurie, got into an argument with Mr. Moriarty over their dogs. "I told him don't do anything stupid," Ms. Hodgetts told the inquest. "Yeah, he was angry, because of the things that have happened in their past." She told the court Mr. Laurie had said there's going to be trouble on the day of the argument about the dogs. "And I said, don't do anything stupid, I don't want to come back and see you in jail," she said. Media player, space to play, M to mute, left and right to seek, 00:00:00:02500:00:00:08:25. Mr. Laurie has denied the argument was aggressive on either side and described Ms. Hodgetts' account as embellishment. "I wasn't angry or aggressive about it," he told the inquest. Mr. Laurie told the inquest he was joking when had earlier told Ms. Hodgetts, "If anyone touches my plants, it'll be the first murder in Larrimah. I had no intention of murdering anyone over a garden," he told coroner Greg Kavanagh. "People have been murdered for a lot less, sir," Mr. Kavanagh said. Mr. Moriarty was last seen on his quad bike, leaving the Pink Panther about 6 p.m., and half an hour later Mr. Laurie made 2 phone calls from a public phone box, the inquest heard. Counsel assisting the coroner, Kelvin Curry, suggested to Mr. Laurie that must have seen Mr. Moriarty on his quad bike from the phone box, but Mr. Laurie denied he saw him. Ms. Hodgetts broke down in the witness box when denying she was lying about her testimony, and said neither she nor Mr. Laurie knew anything about Mr. Moriarty's disappearance. The inquest was told Mr. Moriarty was a creature of habit, and when he did not turn up at the pub one day, and his home appeared as though he had never left it, virtually everybody in the community thought something was amiss. An extensive search has failed to uncover any sign of Mr. Moriarty's whereabouts, or that of his dog. Almost the entire population of Larrimah, which is around 12 residents, were called as witnesses at the inquest. The inquest was due to finish on Friday but has now been adjourned to a later date. Print email, Facebook,